everybody. Please be seated. Took my breath away. I almost forgot I had to start this wedding. Family, friends, loved ones, and all of our guests here today, on behalf of Brad and Jen, and their parents, Chad and Rhonda Larkin, Jim and Donna Lake, please permit me to welcome you, each and every one of you, to this amazing ceremony on this truly exquisite afternoon. This is a beautiful venue, amazing oasis in the desert. I also take this moment to recognize Debbie Lake, Jen's mother, and though she's unable to be with us today in body, we know that she's here in all her spirit. We know that she is smiling down upon us and undoubtedly proud, very proud of her daughter. Not for just today, but for all that she is and all that she's become. Sorry, I gotta stand there for just a minute longer. For those of you who may not know me, I've tried to forget, and good luck with that. I'm Kirk Colvett, the fabulous groom's cousin, and now as a seasoned ordained minister with one previous wedding under my belt. Some of you may have caught my previous performance. I know the bride and groom did, and lucky for us, they decided to roll the dice. Okay, and give me a chance at officiating the wedding today. All joking aside, this is a tremendous honor for me to take part in such a special occasion as Brad Larkin and Jen Lake embark on their marital journey. Okay, our first order of business, without any further ado, is the part every father looks forward to, okay, and that is giving away his daughter. No, I'm kidding. Mostly kidding. It's rather the moment that a father and daughter share. Okay, that precious moment, a moment that will endure long past today, and that is to walk down the aisle together in order to receive and to give the marriage blessing. In honor of this custom and tradition, I respectfully ask who today gives this woman to be made to this man.
I do.
Very good. Thank you. I think I forgot in the beginning where I said you'll have to laugh at my jokes. I'm not sure. Did I forget that part? Okay. All right, here we go. You guys are close. All right, ladies and gentlemen, before we continue with the rest of the ceremony, I must address a small matter of etiquette first and remind you that nothing is more important than what brought us here today. Okay? And anyone who really matters is all here. So therefore, I thank you to silence all cell phones or other noise-generating devices that may accompany you today. And yes, I'm looking at all you children, either by age or by choice. I might fit the choice category.
Forgot to leave that in the room.
Also, you're taking pictures, be conscious and courteous of those around you. Okay, it's not to disrupt their view of the ceremony. Okay. Now to get serious. Today, my beloved. I guess you're supposed to say beloved, because it's something I've learned in my online minister training. Anyways, as I was saying, we're gathered to take part in a celebration, an occasion which I can speak for all of us when I say it brings us great joy and immense happiness to see the culmination of courtship and the beginning of a new chapter in a relationship, powered and steered by love, mutual admiration, and mutual respect. Today, where two stand, they will leave here as one, united together, embarking on life's adventure, stronger and more powerfully than they could have ever alone. They have blessed us all by allowing us to be part of their story, to share with us the love they have found. However, just because they have found each other does not mean they no longer need all of us. Rather, we have an obligation as those who love, care for, and respect them. And being the ones they lean on outside of each other to provide them our steadfast support in their marriage, for the family they are creating, and achieving the dreams they are destined for. Therefore, I call on everyone to please rise and stand with me as a sign that you do, and will always stand behind Brad and Jen in their new life together. Let them hear you. I paid them with the open bar too. Thank you. Please retake your seat.
All right.
Now here comes my favorite part of the wedding ceremony, and it's the part I like to call Father Kurt's musing. Okay. So it's pretty much the part of the ceremony where I do all the talking. That's why it's my favorite. I did instruct our bride and groom that I don't do text, Twitter, face chat, Snapbook, or Instatube. So to receive these great pearls of wisdom, they actually had to come to their own wedding to hear them. So I am positive that my lack of social media presence had something to do with you both showing up. So let's chalk it up for the old school guy. All right. So like the fine, seasoned wedding professional that I am, I knew I have to give up some of my precious time. And it's valuable time, really, to meet with the bride and groom, as they deserve. Get their input about the wedding, maybe some valuable insights, maybe get some material for my sermon. I don't get to this pastoral stuff too often, so. Yeah, I was wrong. It's okay, Brad, it runs in the family, I think. A little inside joke, this happened at a previous wedding I did. Okay, luckily they gave me the address, right? I'm here. They told me show up dressed. Good tip. And they said they'd like me to include a story in the ceremony. Great! That's so awesome. A place to start from, right? Give me a story. Yeah, not so much. All right. So, I'm sitting there waiting, awkwardly, waiting for them to tell me a story that they wanted me to share with you today. I'm still waiting. Okay? However, we've all clearly run out of time. All right? And I said to myself, Father Kurt, don't panic. I do. I refer to myself a third person. It's cool. Father Kurt, don't panic. It'll be okay. This is why they pay you in bourbon. This is why you get doubles at the open bar when everybody else gets singles. Right? You got this. So I told myself, go with what you know. Start with what you know first. So I sat there trying to write something down. And I was about as lost as last year's Easter egg. I'm not going to lie to you. Okay? And this vision popped in my head. It's of the groom's mom. Also known to me as my Aunt Rhonda. Okay, Aunt Rhonda, would you please stand up for everybody? Stand. I just want everybody to get a visual to go along with the story. So as I'm telling them. I pick on aunts at weddings, I'm not sure why. Anyways, so she's in Macy's department store. This is what's coming to me. She's in Macy's department store around Christmas. All right. A little over 2 years ago, standing by herself in line to meet Santa. All right. Follow me. Go with me on this one, people. Stay with me. She gets to the front line, sits on Santa's lap, and he asks her customarily what she'd like for Christmas. And she says, I have 2 grown sons, and I'd really like grandchildren. So Santa says she didn't have daughters. He wasn't sure how much he could help her out. And my Aunt Rhonda says, no. So my oldest boy recently found somebody. I'd like my youngest son to find someone, and it'll double my chances. Santa says he'll do his best. And it was a tall order. So come Christmas morning, after opening all the presents, my Aunt Rhonda, the groom's mom, is looking forlornly at the tree. And her husband Chad says, what's wrong? Did you not get everything you wanted? And Rhonda says, no. She sighs. And it was the one thing I wanted the most. And Chad, concerned, goes, what was it that you wanted? And Rhonda says, I don't know. Maybe a blonde about 5'4". And then just then the phone rang. And it was Brad on the other end of the line. And he told his mom that he had just met someone. So yes, Rhonda, there is a Santa Claus. So I know this may be an odd story to tell at a wedding. Okay? But the groomsman, he happens to be my brother, bet me $100. I couldn't mention my Aunt Rhonda and Santa in the same sentence. I've seen I had to make up a story. I figured I might as well make it profitable. The only true part about the entire story is that Brad and Jen did actually meet on Christmas. So while much of the world, okay, was indulging in the binge drinking of eggnog and the gluttonous greed of opening presents, no truer meaning of the season could be found than with Brad and Jen. A time of year that represents the birth of new beginnings and the gift of everlasting eternal love has manifested itself into the amazing union we are witnessing today. From that Christmas on, their love continued to blossom and bloom and bear the purest of fruit. Now fast forward 2 years. Okay, yeah, sorry, we need to forward to that. It took forever. So after some token deliberation, because I believe in my heart that the decision was truly self-evident, Brad decides the time has come to profess his love and propose marriage. He decides to surprise Jen by taking her to the site of their first date. And he would ask her there. However, getting Jen out of the house was not as easy as Brad had imagined. Instead of racing out the door for that evening of romantic bliss, Jen instructed Brad that she had to clean the fish tank first. So Brad, knowing the store, was anxious to leave, and the waiting had become unbearable. And then a thought came over Brad's mind, and that he found the only woman on earth that actually wants to clean a fish tank. And all of a sudden, he found himself at peace. They finally get out the door, and the date's going perfect to plan. Now has come the time. Brad, like the gentleman he is, drops to one knee, reaches in his pocket, and slowly a circle appears, followed by the number one. And then another circle, and another number one. It was two $10 bills. Now, Brad, there isn't a man here today that's proposed to a woman doesn't wish they could have got away with it for $20. So we applaud your efforts. But Jen, without missing a beat, looks down at him and says, and this is true, you can't buy me. Brad, in his defense, had the ring and such two $10 bills to hide the outline in his pocket. He quickly fished out the ring, and we all know what she said because we're all here today. However, Jen was mistaken when she said she couldn't be bought. She was bought, but not for a diamond ring. And certainly not for $20. But with the most valuable gift Brad had to give. And that was his never-ending affection, sincere respect, and admiration, combined with his undying love. Y'all making me emotional. In essence, he gave... That's a good goal. In essence, he gave all of himself in return for all of her. Now, on a sincere and serious note, and I mean it this time, I did meet with Brad and Jen and talk to them about the relationship and what drew them together, why they, in fact, have fallen so deeply in love. Jen being an ICU nurse for 10 years and Brad being a park ranger equally as long, the answers they gave about one another should not be any surprise. Brad said to Jen that he loves her sense of humor, how much it matches his, that she's unbelievably kind-hearted, gentle, down to earth, easy to be around, and loves with all her heart. Jen in turn said to Brad that he's always happy, and she loves his laugh and his smile, that he's calm in demeanor and extremely generous, willing to drop anything for anyone. He's extremely affectionate and loves to hold her hand, and he makes her look forward to coming home every night. I've come away from my time learning about Brad and Jen's relationship, confident I truly have seen and experienced two people genuinely in love. It's given me great warmth and great admiration for both of them and what they have found for each other. In each other, excuse me. That is the reason why I say I'm honored to be here today. And part of this ceremony to witness something so special that I truly and sincerely mean it. So thank you, both of you, and I wish you all the happiness in the world.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. So that's enough from Father Kurt. For the time being, I do take some liberties
more.
Later.
What?
All right. So I have this part about like facing each other and all. You all are well past that. So we're going to move on to exchanging of vows. This is my second favorite part of the ceremony. All right. So as you express these vows, know they're before each other in the presence of friends and family. So Brad, you're going to start. You're going to repeat after me. Get me sniffling. Just getting this interesting. All right. Okay. I, Brad, promise to take you, Jen.
I, Brad, promise to take you, Jen.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
And in sickness and in health.
When you quote movies.
When you quote movies.
And get the words wrong.
And you get the words wrong.
Good night.
When you're jealous.
When you're jealous.
When the dogs like me more.
When the dogs like me more.
For when you put your ice cold hands.
For when you put your ice cold hands.
On my warm bare skin.
On my warm bare skin.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
For the rest of my days.
For the rest of my days.
Until death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Jen, now is your promise to Brad. Please repeat after me. I, Jen, promise to take you, Brad.
I, Jen, promise to take you, Brad.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For when you ask me.
For when you ask me.
Obscure music trivia questions.
Obscure music trivia questions.
When you have conversations with me in your sleep.
When you have conversations with me in your sleep.
That you don't remember the next day.
That you don't remember the next day.
For even when you try to buy me.
For even when you try to buy me.
For only
$20. For only $20.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
For the rest of my days.
For the rest of my days.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
Ladies and gentlemen, Brad and Jen have just bring their own vows. That they will be given to each other privately, separate from this ceremony. And though these words are for their ears only, I'd like to still take this opportunity to say that with those vows, okay, you two express your binding promises to love, honor, and cherish one another. Okay? No greater and more important words will be said today than those vows. Okay? Those vows are inspired by the love you have for each other that comes from your heart. Now, this is where I'm telling you to join hands. Y'all been doing that the whole time. Fast forward. This is the time for Brad Dooms. I just want to make sure y'all knew your lines, okay? Here we go. Brad, as you stand here today and for every day forward, do you take Jen to be your lawful wedded wife?
I do.
Oh, hang on. Man, you're taking the pressure off me quick. That was because I had half a sentence to go. I'm a supporter completely and love her unconditionally so long as you both shall live.
I do.
Very good. That was just as good the second time. You nailed it. Jen, as you stand here today and for every day forward, do you take Brad to be your lawfully wedded husband? Do you promise to support him completely and love him unconditionally so long as you both shall live?
I do.
All right. It's great that he was that excited. I mean, he can't wait. That's a good sign. Okay. You've chosen a hallmark, your pronouncement of marriage, as well as honoring your vows by the exchanging of rings.
Oh, goodness.
Just kidding.
Fish in there. Get it. No $10 bills. All right. These rings are a representation of your love. The symbol of symbolism, a simple and profound, just as is the union you have made today. A ring is simple in its small circular shape, just as simple as the concept of two people meeting in this small world. Yet a ring is profound in that it is made infinite in its construction, a concept of no beginning or end that is far bigger than its physical size. So too is the profound concept of the love that you two have formed and have for one another that exists beyond the physical into something endless and immeasurable. A ring is simple in the materials it's made of, valued in currency associated by a number. Yet a ring is profound in that it becomes priceless when placed on the hand made to represent our most incalculable gift. Give another, and that is our love. I ask you to remember as you put these rings on your fingers, that you think of it like walking through an open door into the future, and these rings will always remind you, okay, that endless, immeasurable, invaluable love that you share with each other, and that love will be with you every step of the way in all your days ahead. Brad, please present the ring you have for Jen and repeat it after me as you place the ring on her finger. I, Brad.
I, Brad. Oh, I almost dropped it.
Here we go. That's pretty nice. I, Brad.
I, Brad.
Give you, Jen.
Give you, Jen.
This ring, as a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
Good. Commitment to you.
Commitment to you. Words are hard.
And the eternal vow.
Eternal vow.
I'll go slow. We have made to each other today.
Have made to each other today.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
All right. Jen, your turn. Please present the ring you have for Brad and repeat after me as you place the ring on his finger. I, Jen.
I, Jen.
Give you, Brad.
Give you, Brad.
This ring as a symbol of my love.
This ring as a symbol of my love.
Commitment to you.
Commitment to you.
And the eternal vows.
And the eternal vows.
We have made to each other today.
We have made to each other today.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
All right. Very nice. Please turn and face everybody. By the power vested in me by the state of Nevada, before God, and witness of family and friends, it is with great happiness and immense elation that I now pronounce you husband and wife. Congratulations, you may now kiss your bride. Now you really have to face everybody. I'm going to announce you, ladies and gentlemen, please allow me the great honor of presenting to you for the very first time our newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Brad and Jen Larkin.
Flying all alone.
You look amazing.
Flying blind. I've seen it all. I've been around. I've been lost and I've been.
Mr. and Mrs. Larkin.